Welcome to tonight's game. It promises to be a good one between the Maryland Terrapins and the Kansas Jayhawks. And here's a look at our star watch comparison. What's the starting five look like, you might ask? Well, whether it's a big game or a small game, your starting five has got to be ready to go, Dick.
Good shooters are hard to come by, but we have two tonight. If they both start heating up, Brad, we may see some fireworks.
Talk about a hot ticket, Mr. Vitale. These are two of the nation's very best.
When I look at these teams and the players on their rosters, I think talent with a capital T. Nothing but the cream of the crop here, Brad.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, here we go. And we're off with a tip here in the first half.
Up and inside.
In the lane, missed the jumper. So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up, and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Both teams looking to get things going here. Inside. Goes up for two. Can't get it to go. To pack it inside for two. They got it. When you can pass and score like he does, it makes a coach's job a little bit easier, wouldn't you say, Dick?
Tell you, Brad, pass and score at times are very difficult to guard. They're capable of getting off their own shot as well as create for others. He's fun to watch for those reasons.
Nice to have you along with us tonight. Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews alongside. I'm Brad Nessler. We got a good one going. He puts up the three ball. Off the mark. Looking to move it around the perimeter.
Terrific block shot, though. He's a dominator blocking shots on the interior.
The missed shot. He shoots the jumper. Jumper won't go. For the bucket. Goes. Works the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
He fires it up. Doesn't go. Number 12 gets the pass. Gave it up. He attempts the jump shot. They get it to go. On the dribble, gives it up. Goes up for two. Not this time. Number 12 takes the pass. Uncharacteristic mistake by the senior. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc looking for the open jumper. Two. He drains the shot.
Solid work getting back on D.
On the outside. He goes up with it. Nope. Now the rebound.
They need to get out and run their lanes now.
Looking for the pick now.
Hey, the two-man game is great to watch when you have an intelligent dribbler and a skilled big man.
Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket. You know, Brad, as a coach, your seniors are a very important part of their operation. The underclassmen look up to them and really lean on them for guidance and direction. When a senior accepts this role and leads by example, it helps the coaching staff and the team immensely.
Second one is no good. The chanting continues.
Who says there's no such thing as a home court advantage?
And a momentary look from three-point land. From the corner, he misses the fadeaway.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps.
And the fans love it. Jump with joy, fan. Hey, that's my guys yelling.
Looking for a good shot. And we're at the 8-minute mark. Number 12 looks to be down emotionally.
Yeah, it's unfortunate to see this, Brad. I feel for him.
Alexander receives the ball. Tries for two. He hits it. On the outside. Shoots from the top of the circle. He's taking a lot of bad shots out there, Dick.
I know he's trying to catch fire, Brad, but it's just not there.
Both teams looking to get things going here. Lobs it for the bucket. About 7 minutes remaining. The small forward gets the ball. He rejects it. Alexander picks up the foul. Well, he commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, it's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a burst of foul. I like his mentality. No easy basket.
Well, Dick, this young man's now in his second year.
It's important to have kids like this on your team. They've had a year of experience, but they are still hungry to prove themselves to their teammates and coaches.
Might be in a little bit of trouble here, Dick. Goes right through the trap.
That trap didn't scare him, Brad.
Goes up with it. Off the mark. Gave it up. He puts up the J. This guy's really known as more of a power guy.
He knows how to use his strength, Brad. That's such an important skill. You've got to know how to use it without being called for the foul.
Goes up for two. Off the glass and no good. Number 12 receives the ball. 6 minutes left on the game clock. Looking for a good shot. And the ball's out of bounds. We'll go back the other way. You know, Dick, this guy's really elevated his game today.
I tell you, as a coach, Brad, it's always nice to have a player surprisingly step up and perform better than expected. We'll have to keep a close eye on him moving forward.
Work it around the arc with the J. Scores it. They work the perimeter. He tries the jumper. Missed it. Number one takes the pass. Now they work it around the perimeter. He pulls up with a jumper. He drains the jumper. 5 minutes left in the game clock. Working it around the perimeter.
Pushing that basketball.
With the jumper. They just can't find the open seams on the floor.
They're struggling to score right now.
For two, it sticks. Way out on top, controlling the ball. Tries for two, off the glass and no good. Knocks it down. We're at the 4 minute mark.
Look at that spacing.
10 to shoot now.
Try to go inside.
He gets the rejection. Number 12 receives the pass. Now trying to feed the low block. He shoots from the corner. In and out. Moving it around the perimeter. Too physical. Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nessler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
Well, he's just a freshman, but hey, we all got to start somewhere.
Your first year playing basketball at this level is definitely an eye-opening experience. The players are bigger and the game is faster. But if you can adjust and find ways to help your team win, it can be a memorable season.
He hits the second. Number 22 gets his first action tonight, Dick.
You ask me, Brad, this kid could easily be a starter.
Kicks it out. Jumper
didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
We're at the 3 minute mark. They work it around the perimeter from the corner. Nails a sweet jumper. Way out on top, controlling the ball. For the bucket. They're getting no good looks at the hoop tonight, Dick.
I don't know what they're doing, but they're squandering away all those easy looks underneath.
He shoots the jumper. Scorches the net with a J. Both teams are looking to get something going here. Goes up for two. Off the glass and no good. About 2 minutes remaining on the game clock.
They've got a shooter spotting up on the three-point line.
He attempts the jump shot. They really seem to be letting this one get away, Dick.
Yeah, there's been a breakdown somewhere. They need to talk this one over, Brad.
He goes up with it. He takes another bad shot.
Bad shots kill chemistry, Brad.
Fast break opportunity here. Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter. Gets the J to fall. On the dribble, gives it up. He puts up the tray and score it. One minute left to go. For two, shots off the mark. Great defensive clinic put on by this young man tonight, Dick.
You betcha. He's giving the offense the blues.
Off the glass and no good. And it's blocked. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with the blocked shot.
Can't connect. Number one handles the pass. Tries for two and come up short. The small forward with the ball. He looks for the bomb. Time, the Jayhawks are up by 10. Maryland is guilty of poor shooting in that first half, and I mean poor shooting, Dick.
I'll tell you one thing, Brad, you're too nice a guy. I know that, but you're too kind. The one for shooting, they're going through with any ball games.
Finds himself back out on the court.
This team plays a lot differently when he's in the game, Brad.
Is that good or bad, Dick? You
think? I think they play a lot more under control. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
There was no doubt about that one. He cut back door and received the pass.
I tell you, what a great play. That's coaching. That's teaching. That's terrific execution. The back door cut. So you little racer. I love shot blockers. They add such a dimension to your team.
They work it around the perimeter. Takes his jumper. Knocked it down. To get it to the inside. Number 12 is charged with the foul. First team foul. Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits the foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket.
Steps to the line for an easy one. He buries it.
On that free throw line, and that's major.
The student body has got it going on. They look to be filled with rage and eager for a win.
The student body looks like they're ready to terrorize the opposition.
Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket.
They will line him up. Gets the first. Misses the free one. The small forward gets the pass. pick.
Hey, it's important that the dribbler really turns that corner hard when he's using that ball screen.
Hard foul. Well, he commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, it's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy basket. Hey, Brad, you want to get to the line early and often. You end up getting your opponents into foul trouble, and it's also an opportunity to get some points.
Misses the second shot. Gave it up. Goes up for two. Buried it. Dribble, gives it up. From the corner, missed the jumper.
Up and inside.
Obvious foul. I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nessler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
He goes to the free throw line. Gets that one. Misses the second. The small forward handles the feed. Puts up the J. Nails the jumper. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Now the turnaround jumper. Off the mark. For two. Tries for two. He missed. Tipped in.
What a great tip. What a great second effort.
Worked the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
That's a foul. Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits a foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket.
Here's another solid junior, Dick.
You know, Brad, you look at your juniors as third-year players who have been there. Nothing should be new to them by the time they're in their third season. They should know what's expected from them in the classroom, and they should know what to expect from their conference opponents. The level of familiarity should be much higher than what it was in their first year.
Gets his second.
Shooter spotting up on a three.
They've got him trapped. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc looking for the open jumper. He bombs from outside. Jumper won't go. The shooting guard gets the pass. On the outside for three. He makes the jumper. He can't let this guy have the uncontested shot.
He just got to dig in and play some D.
Fed the low block. Jumper.
Hey, when are these guys going to be able to make a shot?
Stone receives the ball, down inside, puts up the jumper, scores it. The Jayhawks have put together a real team effort so far, Dick.
They've been awesome, Brad. Every player who has stepped onto the court has been focused and has been looking to get his team involved. You've got to love this kind of teamwork.
Trying to feed the low block.
A lot of good things happen when you bring the ball down to the inside.
He's whistled for charging.
You gotta look for your teammates.
Oh, and you can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad, bad foul right there, Brad.
He tries the three. I wonder if he's ever going to get any help from his teammates, Dick. He's doing it all and then some.
Call this a one-man show, Brad. I don't know if it's a good thing or a bad thing.
We've got a break in the action, folks. Stay tuned for more ESPN coverage of the NCAA. We get ready to bounce back into action here. And a momentary look from three-point land for the bucket. Comes up short. Zone offense now.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
I tell you, the four around one, spacing's a key. You better have good spacing, and you better have people on the interior that can score with their back to the basket. If you got a big guy who can post up inside and who has passing ability, he's going to create opportunities for the guys on the perimeter.
Goes up with it. Gets the J to fall. We're at the 7-minute mark. Gave it up. He tries the jumper. The missed shot. Dribble, gives it up.
I tell you, nothing like having those legs, man, where you bounce right off the floor.
Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter. Off the mark. And now they'll bring it up. Goes up for two. Gets it to go. There may be a pick and roll here, Dick.
You've got to love the pick and roll, especially when it's run to perfection, Brad.
He nails the bucket. Now that's how you take the ball to the basket.
When you drive with conviction, good things happen. Sometimes it's the basket, sometimes you get fouled.
Swatted from behind.
Never saw him coming, Brad.
Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket.
tell you what an opportunity he's got right here. Because to me, this is a gift.
He can't buy one. Nice defensive rebound.
Fill the lanes. That's the only way they'll be able to get some fast break opportunities.
Jumper. They got it. The Terrapins will play up-tempo at one end and in the half court at the other end. Wouldn't you agree, Dick?
You know, balanced teams will definitely give you a combination of the two styles. Some teams will play up-tempo on offense and be half-court oriented at the defensive end. Other balanced teams may play in the half court offensively and really look to pressure their opponents in the full court.
About 5 minutes remaining in the game clock. Gave it up. And he goes with a spin.
I tell you, feel the defensive player on your hip going one way and you spin back the other way.
Gives it up. The Jayhawks are on the run. Inside. Number 10 is whistled for the foul. Fifth team foul. Well, it commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, it's a smart play, Brian, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy basket.
Opportunity now for an easy one. He hits the first shot.
Makes those free throws count. Let's go back on our campus as BMOC. Big man on campus, baby.
Traps in place, Dick. He escapes the trap.
Right around the trap.
The shooting guard receives the ball. Let's it fly. Rims out. About 4 minutes remaining. Looking for a good shot. He goes up with a jumper. Can't connect. The small forward handles the pass. Big finish coming here, partner. I'm not going anywhere.
Offensively, this is when it's extremely important to have the right people shooting the basketball at the right times.
Lays it up. Side. Now the turnaround jumper. He misses the jumper. Number 10 handles the feed. Looking for a good shot. Looks for a three-pointer. He can't get the hoop to fall. With a layup. About 3 minutes remaining. The small forward with the ball. Dumps it in. For the deuce. And he can't hit the shot. They'll work it around the arc.
Turnover by the senior.
Shots. I don't even think they're giving the ball a chance to go in, Dick.
Confidence has got to be an issue now, Brad. They aren't shooting the ball with any confidence whatsoever. It's Brick City, USA.
We're at the two-minute mark. He buries it. The Jayhawks might be in trouble here, Dick. It might be time to abandon any half-court sets and look at getting some baskets in transition.
Since time and score is not in their favor, they're going to have to change their style. They need points, and they need them fast. I anticipate some sort of adjustment, Brad.
goes up for two. Rims out. Top of the key. There's a slam. A lot of time to go now, Dick, on a 7-point lead.
That's right, Brad. A lot of time. They don't need to start forcing shots.
Alley-oop. Tries for two. Did a great job of getting to the hoop on that one, Richard.
I tell you, he was fearless right there. Did a great job taking it to the rack. And some great concentration to finish scoring.
Launches away. Can't get the shot to drop. Timeout. Let's check in with Aaron, who's standing by.
Well, guys, I'm sure the coaches are using this time to go over crucial end-of-game strategy. Now, often teams will dedicate parts of their practice to special situations and end-of-game strategy. Now's the time when that practice will pay off, guys.
It takes a certain kind of person to be a college coach, wouldn't you say, Dick?
That's for sure. If you want to be the man on the sideline, you have to be ready to accept the world of responsibility. Something is on the line every game. And you have to get everyone on your team on the same page and play it with passion.
And after the timeout, we're all set to pick things up. The Jayhawks here running their zone offense.
Well, the key to zone motion offense is you got to get good ball movement. If you get good ball movement to get the zone, to really slide and use the skip pass to make it tough for that zone to adjust.
Foul them early and give your team a chance.
It's a 3-point deficit.
And that can change in a matter of seconds, baby. Hold on.
Alexander taking it hard to the hoop. What a great take there.
Hey, now that's taking it strong to the hoop. Look at him throw it down.
3 points is the difference.
That's right, so somebody better guard the arc.
I like it when the team gets to the free throw line. It shows that they're being aggressive. The key is to get to the line early in the game and walk.
Second shot is no good.
All you need is a score and a stop to have a chance.
Can we expect a little change in direction here, Dick?
I wouldn't be surprised if the schemes change somewhat.
The Jayhawks running their zone offense here, Dick.
Hey, one thing that works well against zones is overloading the side. Overload a side and force the defense to shift out of their desired position.
And they continue to foul to stop the clock. He'll visit the charity stripe. Misses the front end of the one and one. We're ready to get things back going again after the timeout. Zone motion now. Gave it up. He puts it up at the horn. No good. Kansas can't pull this one out. Very good game.
It's always tough to lose to a team that you know you can beat.
So for Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.